Hey everyone, One Big Boss here. As you can tell by the title of the video that you clicked on, we're talking GameStop, but more specifically, we're talking about the end of GameStop. Now, I know that you've probably seen a billion of these videos already, but I'm going to do something that only really a few people have actually done when it comes to these stories. And I'm not reporting on, you know, how bad the company has been to people, or what it's done to this person or that person, or my personal experiences, which actually for like 99% of the time, I've actually had great experiences with GameStop. No, this is going to be more about why it's a bad thing that something like GameStop is going out of business. First off, we're going to have to go back a couple of years to when a store that me and my friends all worked at, or either just hung out at all the time, and it was a retro game store. It was a store that was great. We had like wall-to-wall TVs. We had consoles hooked up to them. We had TVs everywhere. It was a great place, man. We were playing games like Guilty Gear, and we were playing Resident Evil: The Dark Side Chronicles, and playing. I remember when we all brought our PSPs in to play Metal Gear Solid: Peace Walker. It was an amazing place. We all had fun, and this was a place that you went to go get games because retro games weren't really being heavily collected back then, and you could get them for good prices. You could blow your whole paycheck there. I know a lot of us blew our paychecks there. And, you know, we'd always order from the Papagino's next door or the 99 across the street, have them come over. We're all just eating and hanging out, playing games. Great, amazing, fun times, honestly. It was times that we just really had fun. And then, you know, the rise of GameStop really started happening. And a lot of, you know, retro game stores and mom and pop stores were just, they were gone. Couldn't compete with what GameStop was doing. And for the longest time, GameStop was the only really good place to go and get good deals. Now, I know places like Best Buy had like deals like for games and such, and you know, Target did as well, and Walmart as well, they did too. But overall, when you really think about it, if you didn't trade anything into GameStop, you kind of made out like a bandit. I know I did. Now, one of the reasons I'm making this video, like I said earlier, is the negativity that people kept saying about, oh, I'm glad this is closing, you know, fuck GameStop, oh, the hell with this, I'm not dealing with them, or anything, they screwed me over, or they're just terrible. And I feel like a lot of these people are the ones that are just riding the train of hate without actually having any bad experiences themselves. Now, again, I know that GameStop themselves, corporate level, have done terrible fucking things, not just to the consumer, but to their employees, and it's freaking terrible, because I have friends who work for the company. I used to work for the company too, for their holiday stuff, and I gotta tell you, it was one of the best jobs I had, because I had bosses that respected me, and I had bosses that understood my situation of caring for my father or my photography business if I needed time off, and they were great about it, and I worked my ass off when I was there. I sold the things they wanted me to sell. I sold games, I sold consoles, I was really good with people and everything, you know, and it was great. And here's the problem. If GameStop closes down, where are you going to go to find your physical games? Because don't tell me that nobody cares about physical media anymore. If that was true, then the Switch wouldn't be giving you the physical media that it does. It still offers it. Okay? And where are you going to get them for good pricing? Look, I've seen the price difference between games at Best Buy compared to GameStop. And GameStop beats them almost every time, like 99% of the time, GameStop's beating them, because, you know, you get your rewards membership, and then, you know, you save up the points, you get extra stuff, you know, all this jazz. There is a lot to be gotten at GameStop in terms of their games, where, you know, you go somewhere else and that game's $8 more. On Amazon, it's $8 more used, and with Amazon, you don't know if it's going to come damaged somehow, the disc could be scratched, or this could not work, or it couldn't be the same thing. Then you got to go through the whole big deal of getting everything back together for Amazon, pack it up and send it back, and it's a pain in the butt. Whereas for GameStop, if there's a problem, you just bring it right back right then and there. You know, especially if it's a GameStop you frequent and they know that you're not lying and that you didn't come in and like completely destroy everything. So, I mean, you know, physical media is a dying art in many ways, which is sad to say, because there's still companies out there that make physical games for digital games, such as like this. Limited Run Games makes, you know, they made the Windjammers one, and I had to get this because it's motherfucking Windjammers, baby. I love this game so much. But one of the best examples was, I went into GameStop the other day, and used was Ultra Street Fighter 2, the final challenge, or challengers, I should say. And this thing is like 30 and more used at other places I've seen, like at Best Buy and online, on eBay, Amazon, everything. They had it for 25 bucks, so I picked it up. And honestly, my physical media for the Switch is a lot. And I want to have physical media for my Switch, but I also don't mind have digital for the Switch because of, you know, I know which games I'm going to take on, like, when I travel. But what I'm saying is, what happens when you want to buy physical games for cheap? Look, not everybody's going to be able to drop $60 on a brand new game. All right, and games drop in prices pretty fast this day and age. Unlike they did a couple of years ago, these things are dropping really quick. So if you don't have one at launch and you don't mind spoilers, or you know you're not going to get spoiled, or it's just something, you know, something like that, you want the physical media of it, you're going to be able to, you know, get it for a good price at GameStop. But again, it's the future. I don't know what they could do to stay afloat. It's sad because the big thing of it is I've met some great people working there, and the people that I've met, you know, going through all that, and it just sucks. That's the best way that I can put it. It's just terrible. I feel bad for anybody that's invested years into the company that has worked there. I got a good friend of mine, and I'm worried about what's going to happen to her. She's worked her butt off of this company, and 200 stores are closing. I know they got like 6,000 stores and everything like that, but you know, you don't know what's going to happen. Like, we could hear, like, tomorrow that 700 stores are closing, or 1,000 stores are closing. And it really does make me sad, because I go to a lot of other stores that sell, like, you know, like, old Wii games still, or, you know, Wii U games, and they're still charging, like, a lot of money for them. Where you could just get them at GameStop for sometimes $10, $12, even $15 less. Again, and I like the fact that I can go in there and buy different things. Like, they have, like, all the geek memorabilia. Like, you can buy, like, wallets, and you can buy cool, like, statues and figures and all the stuff that I like to collect that's over here in the closet that you can't see. But, you know, or, I mean, well, you can see some of it behind me on the shelf above. Overall, I'm just sad. I'm sad that this is the way GameStop is going. I think that if they continue doing retro games and taking those in and taking the systems and testing them and things like that, I think that they could have worked out a little bit better. But sadly, this is really the end. Whether or not they're going to survive into like the rest of maybe even this year or 2020, doesn't look good. And again, where are we going to go to find cheap games to play so we don't have to digitally download them? Because again, sometimes digital downloads, everybody says they're amazing, but companies can just take them away like that, and there's no other way to get them except for maybe physical media. So, that being said, please let me know your thoughts and opinions down below in the comments. Let me know, because I'm sad about this. You know, a lot of people are all like celebrating, like, you know, they just won the World Series or something, and they're breaking out the freaking champagne and everything, but for me personally, this is really sad, you know, because I've always had great experiences going to GameStop. I had like one minor issue that was fixed easily, and again, it's just the way it is. These brick and mortar stores aren't going to last much longer out there. It is what it is, I guess. So please, thumbs up and subscribe, because it's free, and in this day and age, free is a damn good thing. As always, everybody, thank you for watching. My name is One Big Boss, and I will see you all next time.